Here we have some exposed pipe. So what I had here was a kind of pothole. Now you would say there's a pothole there, and when I worked on the pothole I found the water pot because there's a leak on the water pot. However, it's not as simple as that. I think this could be coincidence. So we've got an L bend here. We've got the pipe here. This is also exposed, but there's obviously not a leak there. And I think it's the same situation here, that a pothole happened to develop over the top of a join. I've scraped out, so you can see how deep that is there. And on the other side. So first indications are that there's no leaking, there's no wetness. There was a pothole, so you'd expect some dampness. There's some dampness around this side. This tree root ran from here straight through without branching off to the join. And then we had these smaller roots. There's one there and one there. However, the good indication is that that's growing straight up and not branching out across this region, because there was exposed earth there, much in the same way as this area here. That's off to the side of the pipe that runs down there, and that's the other small pothole. So this is looking good for a refill. I don't want to get a small wire brush and scrape out here, because there could be hemp there. I think hemp would have been used as the seal in the join. So that goes down there. On second thoughts, if that was to be the join, the L bend there, that would come out there and go down beside this pipe. So that's a separate issue. However, there is back here a crease. However, the car, when it backs down here, comes fairly close here. And I think when I exit the garage here, I come out wider. What I might do is just position the car as it backs in, just to see what could be causing this. I don't think there's a leak on this side. If there was a leak anywhere, it'd be here. And that's becoming dry. This has been exposed for about half an hour, 45 minutes. The supporting earth underneath is left intact, so that when I put the bitumen down, that there is some support. Okay, just so we know in future where this runs, it runs to the crease there. Okay, there's a bend in the cement, and it runs, we can see here, down virtually just up from the crease there. Okay. I don't think this is going to be a problem. This goes down along here. Recent work has turned it into PVC plastic piping that runs to the tap, and then that runs branches off to a fire system I have on top of the garage. The sewage runs out of the house there. There's a what would you call that? I've built a relief or release into the plumbing system where I've made a cap or I've used a I've just made this hatch here so that it'll overflow there instead of you know, banking up, going higher and spilling out of the systems inside the house. So the plumbing comes down here, I believe, somewhere like here, runs along the side and along the side of the cement slab here and goes into a tank out that way. But that's a separate issue. Also at play here is you can see that this is bowing up along here. So there could be a tree root or something underneath there lifting up the slab. Funny thing is, it's higher on this point, but it runs along, the two slabs run along absolutely evenly there, and yet you've got this rise here, and we can see a crack or a crease running along there. And funnily enough, that runs into the bitumen area here. You just might be able to see it just running along there. So there's a lot going on. As we speak, this is becoming dry and it's looking like, if anywhere, there's a possible very slow leak along there, but I don't think it's really an issue. Because I make a video like this obviously because now's the time to document it. That is, it seems to be a little bit too far this way. It's not directly in, but over time I suppose it's been stretched and, you know, I mean, nothing and no one is perfect anyway, so this looks good. On this side, it's drying up, but we do have the sun behind us. Okay, this side. Before filling it in, I'm looking for this to dry out, but this is a fairly thick crust. Okay. So, you know, the roots not spreading out around this region, also the roots growing directly upwards away from this region. I don't think that this is a problem. Okay, so there's the pothole, and funnily enough, that's right in the middle of where the car will come into the garage and exit the garage. Okay, so in other words, there's no interplay between the car and the pothole. Okay, well that's it for me. I'm satisfied there's no real problem there. It's a hell of a coincidence that there would be a pothole right where the join is. However, coincidences happen, just like we know with the pipe in this area here exposed as well. So I'm just going to wait for that bit to dry. And if it does, I'm just going to fill it in and move on to the next one. I'd just like to say at this point that there is the possibility that this plumbing could have been bypassed and it may not even be used, and it could be just a structure that is over time the bitumen is collapsing over the top of, leaving a crease. So once again, this could have been bypassed or even in the building storage or the building process of the subdivision
this metal piping could have been just placed there out of the way and just built over the top of. Another way to put it is that the actual the water plumbing to the tap could be running parallel or separate to this pipe.
Okay, so the distance now from the second slab to the top of the first slab there is 40 millimetres. So that's 40 millimetres. That little route running along beside the pipe, or the thicker route, the 15 millimetre route, could be coming from a type of growth under the slab here and moving out there. If there was some sort of a small tree or stump growing underneath the slab, I would expect more tree root branching to a water source, like a pothole like that. But anyway, that's all I've got at the moment. Okay, it's about 1.5 hours later, and it's completely dry. Well, a bag of bitumen doesn't go very far. That's close to $60. And there's just a bit of a hole here. And that's virtually just a cover from there to there. So it is hot today. It's ideal weather. It's the surface is prepared. But I wish I had another bag. I'll probably get another bag later on. But that's fairly good. I have replaced this front section here through here. Probably you might be able to see the overlap here. So, you know, that's the same as this. And there's the new stuff there, so yeah, I'll exit here and probably get another bag and just fill that area in there a little bit more. So this is, I'm satisfied, that's okay. This through here. Okay, well, I hope this was interesting or helpful. Please like and subscribe.